Good morning, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese's new front bench has just been sworn in at Government House in Canberra with a record number of women now in Cabinet. Let's bring our federal politics reporter Fiona Whelan in. Fee, good morning to you. It is off to work they go.
Davina, Anthony Albanese says he doesn't want to waste a moment in government, so his Cabinet will meet this afternoon. This morning, though, they've been posing for class photos on the steps of Government House after being sworn in. And something that really stands out about this particular class is the record number of women. So there are 10 in Cabinet, 13 in the Ministry, and that includes the Home Affairs Minister Claire O'Neill and Tanya Plibersek in the Environment and Water portfolio. So that one was a bit of a surprise, given she previously held the education role. Instead, that went to Jason Clare. Now, Anthony Albanese promised to increase diversity, and in a sign of that, two MPs, Anna Lee and Ed Husic, swore on the Quran as they joined the ministry. And WA MP Linda Burney shared an emotional moment with the Governor-General as she became the first Indigenous woman to join federal cabinet. The Deputy Prime Minister, Richard Marles, has become the Defence Minister.
It's a very significant time to be dealing, being the Defence Minister. I'm obviously really excited about the challenge, but I'm really cognizant of the responsibility that comes with it. I think we face the most complex strategic environment that Australia probably has faced since the end of the Second World War.
This afternoon, though, attention will turn to the economy. The Treasurer, Jim Chalmers, will give an update on how things are tracking. Davina?
Welcome back. Well, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has made history this morning, swearing in a record number of female MPs into his front bench. We are seeing this happening right now in Canberra. Our new Prime Minister said that this ministry represents his goal of working towards 50-50 representation more broadly.
Yeah, let's get today's take on this with the Sydney Morning Herald's culture reporter Thomas Mitchell and Nine Honey columnist Maria Vatil. Maria, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Feels pretty good to see more women than ever taking up top jobs, huh?
Taking their rightful space up where the top jobs are.
It's exactly.
Intriguing, but no, it is good. You know, I think we see that women are underrepresented in decision-making spheres, you know, especially in politics. So I think it's beautiful to see so much engagement, because I think that means that we are going to see mobilisation around issues that we care about. Mm. So it's beautiful.
And it's representation across the board with this ministry. Two Muslim ministers, an Indigenous woman in Linda Burney taking on the portfolio for Indigenous Australians. Do you feel, Thomas, that there is a sense of optimism around this new ministry?
I think so, yeah. Like, I mean, I think the whole, generally the vibe from the election is one of, like, you know, it's a feel-good time. You know, it's like we've got a majority government and, you know, even, like, with the Teal movement, you know, it was such driven by women. Like, women have really kind of made themselves heard in this election. So I think this ministry does have every reason to feel optimistic. And I also think, you know, like, let's be honest, the first year in the job, everyone tries really hard. Mm. So, like, you know, it'll be, you kind of like lull your boss into a false sense of security.
So you're giving,
and then year two,
you're giving them 1 year.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Year two, you sort of like
let
take
everyone.
Your break.
Thanks for bursting the bubble, Thomas.
I mean, look, gotta be real.
All right.
Gee, there are some big dramas ahead, though. I mean, they're going to earn their keep, aren't they?
I mean, look, you know, again, the first year will be tough, no doubt. But I do think, you know, it seems an incredibly capable government. They're coming in off what should be, you know, this really kind of energised movement. Mm. And I think, yeah, if there's ever a way to start a new government, that's kind of the way to do it.
Okay.